until next time, make it a good one, guys. Later. Woo! That's a wrap, finally.
Dude, it's like 5 a.m. You finally finished?
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure I didn't stutter any of my lines, you know?
Yeah, well, you ain't gonna get it perfect every time. Bro, look at this comment.
What's this? That GoPro footage looked like you tend to step with your heels with intentional shakes with Ronin SC compared to GoPro footage of the Weeble S. Looks biased. What?
Yeah, I know.
Which clip is he talking about?
Is this one.
Oh, yeah, that's one of my old gimbal comparison videos. Dude, I worked so hard on that video to try and make it fair.
Yeah, which footage did you actually record first, though?
I think Weeble S.
you need to do more cardio.
Yeah, I did like 3 to 4 takes, but I guess I can understand the guy.
What? Dude, he straight up called you a liar without even knowing you. You should totally say his name on screen and call him out.
Nah, you can't judge a man with just one comment. Besides, this is like problem with all the YouTube gimbal tests. You really can't step exactly the same way each time you test different gimbals, you know? Especially if you're out of shape, apparently.
Well, that's gonna be a problem then. Aren't you supposed to be comparing the new Crane 2S footage with the Ronin S?
Yeah, that is gonna be a problem. Unless if you could build a rig that's strong and light enough to carry two gimbals at the same time, and if you could somehow track the test footage from both gimbals and export that into a spreadsheet data where you can calculate and score the result in a mathematical way.
Yeah, that sounds impossible. You go ahead and do that. I'm gonna go hang out with Gerald and Dunn. By the way, you got a package from lensrentals.com.
Sweet, perfect timing. Let's build this thing. Guys, I had the final calculated score of the Crane 2S and Ronin S right here. Before I reveal the results though, I want to explain how the test was conducted because I was even shocked by this numbers right here. So the camera setup I put on both gimbals were Sony a7 III with Sigma 24-70 DG-DN, which is my go-to setup now, but fairly on the heavy side at 1,485 grams or 3.27 pounds. I'll need to thank lensrentals.com for providing me with the second camera setup. I'll do a whole episode about like renting versus buying gear, but for a one-time gear use like this, yeah, renting is definitely the way to go. I'll leave their website information along with my 15% coupon code right down in the description if you guys ever want to rent gears in the US. All right, so for this setup, I took the time to really balance both gimbals at 42 millimeter, which is what I usually do for my run and gun video shoots, since I can reach 24 millimeter or 70 millimeters quickly without rebalancing the whole gimbal. I had the infamous GoPro Hero 4 with that image stabilization on my chest and RX100 on top of the rig, so you can see how much shake there is, but I purposely did not do that ninja walk since I wanted to like push these gimbal to the limit at the same time. I ran up and down that tennis court several times, but here's what the sync sample footage looked like at 42 millimeters, and both gimbals were in lock mode since pan follow mode would have turned the gimbals with different sensitivity. Now for the real stress test, straight from there, I changed the focal length to 70 millimeters. In a real wedding shoot, this would have been the case where the bride's dog is in the wedding party and is all of a sudden like too far away. Bam, 70 millimeters for the both gimbals, and now the dog is moving. Here you can really start to tell which motor is much more responsive and stronger, but still subjective. Don't worry, we're going to put numbers to this movement. So when I got home, I got to work. I synced all the footage to each other down to a frame, tracked the yellow X in each of the test footage, and exported the X-axis and Y-axis position data per frame onto a spreadsheet. I then took the delta of each frame and averaged it out as the final score. You guys ready for the actual score? If you still think the score is not fair, stick around and I'll share with you all the things I consider to make this as accurate as possible. Now keep in mind that 0 is the perfect score where the yellow X is completely still and doesn't move. Here we go. At 42mm, Ronin S score 0.75 and Crane 2S score 0.51. And here's the kicker. At 70mm, Ronin S score 1.73 and Crane 2S scored 0.7. That's 59.5% better performance. And that's where I was like really impressed. It's like Crane 2S didn't care, you just zoomed the heavy lens. I knew Crane 2S had their 9th in-tune motor algorithm, but I wasn't sure how much better it was just by looking at the footage. So that, my friends, is the new next level gimbal test. And I think we can agree that the gimbal smoothness comparison test will never be the same again on this channel. I need a good name for it though. Square pace test, Say's objective gimbal integration test. Nah, how about walk in the Say Park gimbal test? Yeah, I'm just gonna go with that for now, but let me know in the comments if you got like a better name. Since this is the first walk in the Say Park gimbal test, I'll share the things that I had to consider to increase the accuracy of this test. Obviously, first is making sure that the two identical cameras have the exact same settings. I shot both at 120 frames per second for better frame calculation data with autofocus off, so it doesn't hunt in the middle of the shoot. IVIS, of course, was also turned off. I also made sure that the lens support brackets were on both gimbals on the exact same spot, so the camera isn't jittering in the mount. I did auto calibrate both gimbals at 42mm focal length, just like I would in real life, and I even made sure that the batteries were full on both gimbals just in case it would under voltage towards the end of the battery life. Lastly, delta was calculated always from the previous position rather than the initial starting position, and the x-axis and y-axis were calculated separately since smoothness in our eyes are defined by each consecutive frame rather than where you start the frame with. I think one thing I could have done better is maybe not run towards the target. I had to like do multiple runs back and forth, and I could have done more rounds if I wasn't like so tired after 6 rounds of running. Gimbal won't care if I actually run or just shake in one place. I'll keep refining this test, but let me know in the comments if there's anything else I should do to make this test even better. And guys, this is just one aspect about two gimbals. There's more to it than straight line, raw power, and smooth algorithm, of course. You just gotta educate yourself on what's important to you and pick out the best gimbal that meets that. There are plenty of videos about Ronin S, but if you wanna know more about Crane 2S, I did an initial impression review video right here, and I'll also be doing a full long-term review video soon. Meanwhile, I'll see what else I can revolutionize, so make sure you subscribe and hit that bell notification so you don't miss out. Thank you so much for joining my journey, guys. Until next time, make it a good one. Later.